And we turn now to jobs in America and made in America. Last night we took you across the country to that home built entirely with American goods. We mean every screw, every plank of wood, a kind of roadmap to creating nearly a quarter of a million jobs. And tonight ABC's David Muir goes straight to the men and women who build those homes to ask them if they will take our Made in America challenge.
It was a formula for creating jobs so intriguing, we traveled to 2,100 miles to Bozeman, Montana, to see it for ourselves. The flags flying, the ones painted on, and then that home with its own patriotic promise.
Increase the house here.
The builder convinced it will pave the way for hundreds of thousands of new jobs right now. We made our way to the front door, and inside is the first thing we hear. Those three words, Made in America.
Every piece in here is made in America. Every nail, every screw, every piece of tape, the paint on the floor.
Anders Lewandahl is not just a builder. He holds a degree in economics, and he also holds that list of American products he found all over this country to build this entire house. And remember just how many states are represented?
Washington, Indiana, Ohio.
33 states and counting.
North Carolina, Texas.
And you'll remember his simple challenge for others. If every builder used just 5% more American materials, he says we'd create 220,000 jobs right now. And that's just 5% more. But what do economists say? We asked the team at the respected Boston Consulting Group. They told us his numbers do add up.
5% more? Is he right? Could that really create jobs?
It will create jobs. It will absolutely create jobs.
So our team faxed and emailed that blueprint, that list of American materials, to builders all over the country. We're hearing back already in Oklahoma.
Wow, that is an extensive list right there.
This contractor, Tarek Saad, got on the phone and started ordering while we were there. The nails first.
Do you guys supply the gun nails, a manufacturer of maize? You do? Okay, and they're American made, right? Okay. Let's go ahead and get that set up.
And this architect in Miami, Florida, was surprised as soon as she started reading the list. Moen, those faucets, sinks, showers.
I thought it was a German company.
It's American, and she says she'll buy the American items priced the same as the foreign ones. And on Facebook, so many of you wrote about joining in too. My son-in-law is a contractor. I'm going to print out that list. One woman said her husband in construction has worked just one job in 32 years that had that requirement. All products be made in the USA. And Paul, a remodeler from Michigan, who went to our website and got the list, he says if 5% will make a difference, I'm going to try for 10% or more American-made products. And remember those American nails we showed you last night? A little more expensive than foreign nails, but the flip side we told you about?
The American nails jam the nail gun far less often.
So today we wanted to meet the people who make those nails. 1,400 miles from Bozeman, Montana, Mays Nails, Illinois.
We're very, very proud to be one of the last makers of nails in this country.
90% of nails now come from China. But here they use high carbon steel and a double coat of zinc. They make them stronger and rust proof. If they could double their sales, they say, they'll add 25 more jobs. And so many American companies told us they could hire two if this one builder's idea catches on. Companies like Gorilla making that duct tape reaching high in Ohio, the caulking guns, taking aim at Sherwin-Williams in Georgia, and in Pennsylvania, right down to the kitchen sink from Moen. They got it in the picture. All of the workers with the same message for that builder back in Bozeman.
Thank you for choosing American Nails.
Made right here in Illinois.
Made right here in Illinois.
Love those.